Hello friends, now we are discussing the radius of curvature in the polar form. The notation here we are using rho. So let me consider the formula. Rho equals to we have here r square plus r1 square to the power 3/2 divided by r square plus 2 times of r1 square minus r into r2. So here we are using r1 nothing but dr by d theta notation, and r2 we are using here as d square, double derivative of r with respect to theta, d square r by d theta square. So now we will consider one simple example of the polar curve, how to find the radius of curvature. So here we have find the radius of curvature, find the radius of curvature for the curve. Here we have the curve r is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. This is the given curve. We have to identify the radius of curvature. So let us see the solutions, how we are going to simplify the radius of curvature for the given curve. So here we have the solution part. Solution, we'll consider the given curve, that is r is given by r equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. So this is I'm calling as equation number 1. So before differentiating, first let me apply the logarithm, it becomes simple. So apply the log function on both sides. So we will have log of r is equal to, here we can write it as log of a into 1 plus cos theta. So this is applying the log on both sides. So here we have log of r as it is. We know log of m into n is log of m plus log of n. With the help of logarithm function, we can convert this as log a into log of 1 plus cos theta. So now I'll call this equation as 2. That is the given equation as equation number 1. Equation 2 is after applying the logarithm function. So now I'll differentiate equation 2 with respect to theta. So now we'll differentiate equation 2 with respect to theta. So here we have 1 by r into dr by d theta, that you know we are taking as r1, which is equal to derivative of log a is 0. Differential of log of 1 plus cos theta is 1 by 1 plus cos theta into derivative of cos theta we have minus sine theta. So this is the equations we are getting now. So here I'll write r1 by r as it is. The RHS part what we have here is minus of sine theta divided by 1 plus cos theta. So this we have to convert with the help of the formula. As we know here, we will replace the sine theta place as 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 and cos theta by 2, and similarly 1 plus cos theta we can rewrite as 2 times of cos square theta by 2. With the help of these two formulas, we'll simplify the given example. So let me substitute now. So here we have r by r1. So r1 is the first derivative divided by r. We'll simplify the RHS part. This is I'm writing as 2 times of sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 divided by, we have here 2 times of cos square theta by 2. So here 2 get cancelled, 1 cosine get cancelled. Here we have minus tan theta by 2, as sine by cos we know tan. So therefore we got the value of r1 as minus of r into tan theta by 2. This is my equation 3. So we got the first derivative of r. Similarly, we'll go now for the second derivative of the equation 3. So what we'll consider here now? Now I'll differentiate the equation 3. So let me differentiate now. To differentiate equation 3, differentiate equation 3 with respect to theta. differentiate equation 3 with respect to theta. So derivative of r1 becomes r2 now, which is equal to, here I have to apply the product rule. So r is a function of theta, so minus sign I'm keeping outside. So first r as it is, derivative of tan theta by 2 we have here, secant square theta by 2 into derivative of theta by 2 we have 1 by 2. Okay, so plus derivative, the tan theta by 2 I'm keeping as it is. Again, the derivative of r with respect to theta, that I'm replacing as r1. So here r2 is equal to, if I'll substitute the value of this, so this I'm getting as minus of 1 by 2 into r secant square theta by 2 is the first term, and the second term also have negative sign, tan theta by 2 as it is. But what is r1? I can substitute here. My r1 value is, here we have minus of r into tan of theta by 2. Let me simplify first r2, then we can substitute the formula. So here we have r2 is equal to minus of 1 by 2 r secant square theta by 2, and here minus into minus plus, I have r into tan square theta by 2. So we got the r1 value, r2 value. So now I think we have to consider the radius of curvature formula. So rho is given by, here we have r square plus r1 square to the power 3 by 2 divided by r square plus 2 times of r1 square minus r into r2. So this is my equation 4. Equation 4. So before substituting equation 4, first we'll simplify the denominator term. It will be easy. So now I'll consider the denominator first. We have here r square, 2 times of r1 square minus r into r2. So we will simplify this. R square I'm keeping as it is, plus 2 times of r1. So 2 times of, here I'm getting r square into tan square theta by 2. Okay. So next, minus r into r2, already have got the r2 value. So if I'll substitute here, I'm getting minus into minus, first term as plus sign. As you can see, r into r, r square by 2 into secant square theta by 2. And the last term minus into plus, we have minus sign. R into r is r square into tan square theta by 2. So you can observe the first and second term. You can subtract these two because these two are similar. This one, here we have 2 times of r square. You can observe here 2 r square tan square theta and minus r square tan square theta by 2. We'll have plus r square tan square theta by 2. That we'll write now. That we'll consider. So this is equals to, this is equal to, this is we have now. I'll write. So here, which is equals to r square as it is, 2 r square minus r square. Again, I'm having r square only, into tan square theta by 2, okay, plus of r square by 2 into secant square theta by 2. So here I think we can take r square common. So if we'll take r square common, which is left out term, let me have 1 plus tan square theta by 2, and plus here I have taken tan square already outside, this is 1 by 2 into secant square theta by 2. So which is equal to, just you observe these two, 1 plus tan square, from the identity I can make it as secant square. So that we'll have in the next step. So which is equal to r square. Here I'm replacing 1 plus tan square as secant square theta by 2 and plus half of secant square theta by 2. Exactly both are same. So just we have to add by taking the LCM. So if we'll take the LCM, I'll take r square into secant square theta by 2 outside. So here I have, if I'll take the 2 LCM, I'm getting 2 plus 1 as 3. So therefore, the denominator term now reduced to, which is equal to, we have here 3 by 2 times r square into secant square theta by 2. So now I'll substitute these values in the equation 4. So now equation 4 becomes, equation 4 becomes, so we have here the radius of curvature as rho is equal to, substitute now, here we have r square plus of r1 square. So what is r1? I have r square into tan square theta by 2 is my r1. That I am substituting now. Whole to the power 3 by 2. Denominator term just now we completed. We got the value as 3 by 2 into r square into secant square theta by 2. So this is the substitution in the formula. We substituted. In the numerator, I think we can take r square outside. But square and this will get cancelled. Here we have r square to the power 3 by 2 separately. And here we have 1 plus tan square theta by 2. Whole to the power 3 by 2. Okay. Divided by denominator, I am writing the same. 3 by 2 into r square secant square theta by 2. So if you simplify this, we'll get it now as you can see 2 to get cancelled here. So which is equal to, I'll get it as r cube into here 1 plus secant square, just now used as secant square theta by 2 to the power 3 by 2. These two get cancelled. Denominator will retain as it is r square secant square theta by 2. So here 1 r square get cancelled. If you'll take the reciprocal of 3 by 2 to the numerator, I'm getting 2 by 3 into r first term, and here square get cancelled, will have cube divided by secant square theta by 2, and here also square and cube get cancelled. So therefore the radius of curvature in the polar form for the given curve, we have here 2 by 3 into r into secant theta by 2. So this is the solution of the radius of curvature in the polar form. Thank you.